No, not really. I mean, there was a period where we were not refereeing at all. So in the first lockdown, football stopped. So that was great. Coincided with us getting everything onto Discogs and getting the website up and running. But since July, we've been sort of fully back into it. So I've been refereeing, and then the shop got going again. We've moved premises to a bigger shop. So yeah, it's just been a really hectic year, even though the shop's been shut for the last 3 months. The online stuff it's been a blessing in disguise, in a sense, because it's allowed us to get our online presence, get a brand out there on the internet and stuff. So started with Discogs, which was new to us. We always wanted to just have it as a place where you came and chose records, but now we realise with the modern times we've got to move with those. And but it's been good. It's been a good experience. We've got online presence, and I think it's probably will benefit us as a shop going forward. Really. Slightly different to everything else, because whereas you can get everything from online, records are a bit of part of the enjoyment of buying records is you can get one online, which is a new release, but part of the enjoyment as a record collector is going to a record shop and buying stuff that you didn't really realize you wanted, or you'll see something in a record shop that you've not seen for years, and that'll start you on a journey trying to get all the back catalog of that record, that artist, because record collectors, we find this a lot when we buy collections of people, they tend to buy the same thing by every, so they'll get a new artist, let's say it's the Smiths, and they'll get everything by the Smiths, and then they'll go on to someone else and get everything by them. So I think with record shops, there's nothing, no better feeling than going to a record shop and just browsing through the racks. I think I've always liked the idea of having my own record shop, and when I used to, as I do now, when I'm in a city before a match, I'll often go as a way of pre-match, because we have to be there before, I'll often spend some time in different cities' record shops, so I had a good idea of what a good record shop looked like, ones that I enjoyed going to, and I thought, well, I could have a go at this. Me and Julie had sort of had an idea about having a coffee shop, and then we thought, put both things together. I think record shops, the traditional model, is moving away from that. You know, we've got some great places now that sell records, beer, records, pies, you know, and coffee. And so literally February we came up with the idea of the record shop. April we signed the contract and we're opening in July. It was that quick, and then it was just a case of getting as many records as possible. And that was the best thing about having the record shop is no one can tell which records I'm buying for myself, so I've now got a license to buy as many records as I want, which is really all I really want to do. I don't take a wage as such out of the shop, I just take records, so that'll do me for now. Demanding, especially online, when you know the grading of the records, the way the packaging, the way you transport. I think it's been a real eye opener, and you know, sometimes there's no pleasing some people. The customer obviously is always right, but you've also got to be realistic. When I buy a record, I buy it to play and to listen to. I realize not everyone's like that. Some people like to just keep it on the shelf, so we've got to cater for those and try and be as accurate as possible. But I think record collectors, the top end ones, are really demanding. I think I'd much rather just spend an afternoon, 90 minutes on the football pitch with the Premier League footballers.